The House comes to questions for oral answer. Question number one, in the name of Jacinda Ardern.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. My question is to the Prime Minister and asks, does he stand by his government's previous support of, quote, evidence-based investment practices, end quote? If so, does the government intend to send young people charged with serious offences to a military camp, despite the Prime Minister's science advisor saying boot camps don't reduce reoffending?
The Right Honourable Prime Minister.
Mr. Speaker, in answer to the first part of the question, yes, it's important that if you want to achieve results with public spending, you need to know what works. In answer to the second part of the question, what we have announced is a defence-led training academy involving 12 months of intensive wraparound support for 150 of the most challenging young people in New Zealand as an alternative to them serving out their sentence in prison. This is a new policy. It has not been tried before. We are not prepared to sit back and allow ongoing lack of success in changing the lives of the most challenging 150 young people in the country.
Supplementary.
Order. Supplementary question. Jacinda Ardern.
Supplementary. What evidence did he take from the failed corrective training camps he's used in the past and the failed boot camps he used in 2009 to these new boot camps?
Order. The Right Honourable Prime Minister.
Well, Mr. Speaker, the member may be pleased to know that for some of the young people, quite a number of the people in those schemes, they did work well. But it is part of our approach to take the lessons from what has been tried, to change it, improve it, and tailor our programs to the needs of small groups, families, and individuals. And in this case, 150 young people who have been convicted of the most serious crimes with sentences up to 14 weeks. Labor's approach is to roll out lightweight branded programs without any care as to whether they work or not, spending taxpayers' money to show they care.
Order. Supplementary question. Jacinda Ardern.
Supplementary. Did he consult the Children's Commissioner and former Principal Youth Court Judge Andrew Beecroft before implementing this policy, who says sentencing youth offenders to boot camp is, quote, arguably the least successful sentence in the Western world?
First of all, it would be inappropriate to consult the Children's Commissioner on a party policy. Secondly, He has made the mistake of listening to the Labor Party's description of the policy. The policy is not 6 weeks of short, sharp time in a tent living in a tent doing push-ups. The policy is 12 months intensive wraparound for young people whose sentences range up to 14 years because they've committed murder, rape, aggravated robbery, and we never give up on these young people. We believe there's always hope and we can always do better than sending them to prison where they learn how to live a life of crime.
Order. Substantially less interjection from both sides of the House, please. Order. I've just asked for less interjection. Supplementary question, Jacinda Ardern.
Supplementary. Why does he think it's important to give young offenders practical life skills, but the idea of teaching those same skills Labor has called for as part of its school leavers toolkit would cause, quote, chaos, as he said yesterday?
Well, order. Mr. Speaker,
Order. Right Honourable Prime Minister.
Well, Mr. Speaker, I'd certainly be happier talking about our policy than that policy, because it sums up the difference. You see, Well, the Labor leader raised it. The Labor policy is a typical, broad brush, loosely specified, aimed at no one in particular to try and show you care. Our policy is adapted and tailored to the particular group and their needs, designed to change lives. Our policy is about the serious young offenders. Labor's policy is about a lightweight announcement to fill the media for a day.
Supplementary.
Looking anxious.
Order. Order. Supplementary question, Jacinda.
Supplementary, why is he opposing a plan supported by employers, local government New Zealand, and schools to give our young people the practical skills they need in adult life, like driving, like workplace skills, and like budgeting?
What about maths?
The Right Honourable Prime Minister.
Well, Mr Speaker, we're not opposing a plan. We're opposing a reheated, lightweight announcement, which is opposed by secondary school principals. The government is focused on policy that is tailored to the needs, particularly of our most vulnerable and most challenging. And the money that member might want to spray around to show Labor cares, we are focusing on grappling with some of New Zealand's most challenging social problems. And in this case, the 150 most difficult young people in New Zealand. And if we can change their lives, then we change things for this country for the next 30 years.
Supplementary.
Order. Supplementary question, Jacinda Ardern.
Supplementary, has he seen the evidence from the AA, which shows that through things like issuing free driver's licence and driver training, we have the opportunity to deal more effectively with young drivers, reduce offending and fines, and reduce the burden on our courts while supporting young people?
Order. The right. Order.
Well, Mr Speaker,
right Honourable Prime Minister.
Mr Speaker, the difference here is Labor want to show they care. This government actually cares. That's the difference. ANC, the member may not know, there are already a number of targeted driver licence programs designed to reduce driver offending and enable employability with those young people who actually need it. The member may also not be familiar with the trend that fewer young people are getting their licences. I would have thought, as a member for an inner city metropolitan seat, she would know that.
Supplementary.
Order.
Supplementary.
Order. Supplementary question, Jacinda Ardern.
Supplementary, will he join with me in investing? Genuine offer. Will he join with me and invest in young people using programs that work and will make a difference and will help young people to make a contribution to New Zealand rather than investing in failed programs that nobody else supports?
Right Honourable Prime Minister.
Well, Mr Speaker, our measure isn't political support for a program. Our measure is whether we can change the lives of 150 young people whose lives have been defined by violence, by fragmented families, by drug and alcohol addiction, by sexual abuse and serious criminal offending. And frankly, I don't care if there isn't broad political support. We care about changing the lives of these most challenging young people.
Order. Question number two, James Shaw.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. My question is to the Prime Minister.